Foosball Club is literally inside a grain bin out on the farm.
So we end up getting quite a bit of dust.
And that can slow down your bearings and mess up your shots. My friends just told me about Ryan Knapton, an amazing foozer and snowboarder who posted a video on how to fix bearings. His video link is in my description, and right now we're going to scientifically show how well it works. Before we refurbish the bearings, we're going to do a test and see what the sliding friction is on these rods. I've tied a brick to the handle to represent the weight of your hand on the rod. Here's a paracord tied from the rod through a pulley down to a peanut jar. Let's see how many foosballs it takes to pull the rod over. Fifty-two foosballs. Now we'll take out our bearings and take out one rod unless you have a spare. Grab your lube and we'll work Ryan's magic. If you look closely, this is just a connector and that's the bearing, and you can see it's pretty worn. First, we wash them really well. I like 409 because it really cuts the grease. Watch Ryan's video to get the full details, but basically he takes 2000 grit automotive sandpaper, which is this, wraps it around the rod and grinds down these bearings, and then he uses a paper bag to polish it to a fine shine. Two quick polishing tips. One, never run across that hole or you will grind a slot in your bearing. This second one is subtle but very important. The bearing actually sits on the rod like this, not down like that. So when you're polishing, you need to press up here and make sure you maintain that gap. After doing this for a while, I have two other sanding tips for you. One, it's helpful to sand this way some. And two, it's helpful to wash off your sandpaper every once in a while with hot water and a scrub brush. Man, that was a lot of work, but the results are very nice. Here's an old bearing and you can see it's all scuffed and scratched. And after refurbishing, look at that, completely nice glassy finish all throughout. Basically, you want this bearing to look as new as this connector material, so it should be just as shiny if you're doing it right. Lastly, Ryan says, clean your rods. We need to do the testing, but my initial reaction is, holy cow. These rods are lightning fast. So how many foosballs will it take to pull the three rod with the refurbished bearings? 20. That's 2.6 times faster. Ryan's method really works. This is so incredibly helpful for the snake shot. A big thanks to Alex Nagy for doing the club's foosball bearings. Now that you have faster rods, learn or improve your pull, push, and snake shots with a training system from any of these fine vendors. Thanks for watching and good luck improving your foos.